functional and we're seeing right now aerobatic performance. Despite being only manufactured in 2013, the Aero Rep has been certified with an unlimited aerobatic and induced by pilots competing in the challenge cup. Strength and durability. All in all, the extra 330 extra light, or XLX, is a lightweight and robust airplane, and it's ideal for the pilots flying in the Red Bull Air Engine. Let's keep an eye on this young man as he performs a spectacular aerobatic sequence here today, pushing both the airplane and his body to the extreme. How about that, folks? Take our airplane and turn it right here over in. This airplane to read the books about aerodynamics and aerospace engineering, and he gets an unbelievable amount of performance. There he goes again, taking the airplane, turning it around on its wingtip, right over there on the left hand side, pushes forward, he's upside down, he's right side up, and he never takes off opportunity to fly. A slow and then a flick roll. That is the amazing roll rate of the airplane. He can roll it about the speed of a 78 RPM record. And he goes on a 4-point roll on the up side. He pulls the airplane against the blue, beautiful blue sky we've got today. Pulls the stick back to his belly button, pumps out the top, and here he comes back down the line. Let's get the airplane flying. He's got the smoke system on it now. He gives us a step roll. And he's sending us a coded message. I don't speak that. Inside loop, less than 2 lengths of the airplane. He's going to push it over the outside. 6 negative G's trying to pop him out of his seat as he goes across the top. And then another series of step rolls across the sky here at Seymour Johnson. This young man developed himself into a spectacular pilot, flying in the Red Bull's air race sequence all across the world, and then his freestyle aerobatics that he's able to perform for us here today is absolutely unreal. Kevin will be going up later this afternoon. He'll be flying twice. He'll be going up with one of our other pilots and performing a dual aerobatic routine. Right now, he's taking a short breath. If you look at the cockpit of an airplane, you see more clocks than you've ever seen before, not on telling the right time. But they do communicate to the pilot what he needs to know about the condition of his engine. And Kevin is flexing maximum performance out of this engine as he continues to get way up. There he comes with a couple of bursts of smoke so we can spot him. He's got a lot of energy built up in the Wells Fargo bank. He's going to change that energy, which is like money in the bank, into airspeed as he puts the nose down and the airplane starts to accelerate. Those little squiggles in the smoke lights trail you're seeing as the airplane snap rolling. And here he goes. Up high, up into the vertical. Climbing, up. He's going to fly right on the top of our airspace as he starts a series of aileron rolls. The airspeed bleeds off. And there he is, hanging the airplane almost motionless in this beautiful blue Carolina sky. All right, here he comes down. Inverted flat spin. He's got the airplane upside down. The airplane is not flying. Thank you. You scare me when you know those inverted flat spins. Most pilots are taught to them. Inside of the aerobatic area, one more time, into the vertical. That's for the cheap seats down there on the left. There you go again, another maximum deflection aileron rolls, and right there, the airplane stopped again, he stalled, and flown out upside down. You hear the pilot come on, the flight crew say,
just hanging there.
Out for those bananas again, Roy. get the airspeed back up, you can hear this, the airplane start accelerating. It sounds like all this concentration. Right down and go for steering altitude. He goes into another vertical maneuver. Again, maximum power on the flight. There he goes into a shoulder spin while going up. And now holds the airplane running position and belly jumps one more time. Everything that goes up must come down with it. Young man, flat by this airplane. Keep your eye on him as he goes in for one, two, three, step rolls. At the top of the loop, you do one, it's called an avalanche. You do two, it's a super avalanche. You don't want to be in there with him right there about that time. However, on the left-hand side of the airspace once again, into the vertical. Sweep it back around, remaining inside the box. And there he goes, in the airplane. And you can hear that propeller saying, I really don't like that. One more time, right there. Down here. It's on the right hand side. It does a snap roll. You can hear the propeller. There he is, sitting out over on the Y axis and setting himself up over about 1,000 feet from the Y. There he goes. Let's see if the wind's going to cooperate with him. Taking the airplane up. Smoke is off. Thinks he's got something up his sleeve. He's going to take the airplane and give us the Harrier pass where he actually takes the airplane and suspends it on that propeller. His limiting factor is the sun and head temperature. It's the no air cooling air going through the Cali. He's got to keep his eye on that, make sure he doesn't exceed the operating temperature of the engine, but now he's got his tank.
He's got that huff for good.
Stop. Just a moment. He is going to have a nice cool bottle of water, and he's going to be preparing to fly the airplane again in just a few minutes later in our program. But I hope you get the opportunity to meet Kevin. His unbelievable ability to fly that airplane being shown to us here today.
When he comes in, I gotta go for a walk, okay?
Okay. Okay, he's in.
Kevin, he's flying the airplane down the runway a little bit.